Hindu marriage under Hindu Marriage Act. Hindu Marriage Act came in the year 1955 on 18th May. So under Hindu Marriage Act, the first thing which we are going to see, what is the nature of Hindu marriage, whether it is sacramental or contractual. Then we will come down to conditions of valid Hindu marriage. Under conditions of valid Hindu marriage, we have section 5 of the Act, which talks about few conditions. The first one is monogamy. Second one is mental capacity. Age of the parties and consent. Degrees of prohibited relationships, sabinda relationship. So these are the conditions which is there to prove that there should be a valid Hindu marriage. So when we talk about monogamy, it means that neither party has a spouse living at the time of marriage. We do not promote more than one spouse at the time of marriage, right? Now, when we see section 7, there is a term, solemnization of Hindu marriage, or we can say ceremonies under Hindu marriage, and that leads to our first question, that what is the nature of Hindu marriage? It is sacramental in nature, because there we see that in Hindu marriage we follow some rituals. There are different ceremonies. There are a sacred fire. You take 7 steps around a sacred fire. These all are rituals which make the Hindu law what? Sacramental in nature rather than contractual. Then we have doctrine of factum valid, where it shows that ceremonies, what are the essential ceremonies and what are the non-essential ceremonies. Then under section 8, we have registration of Hindu marriage, and by many famous landmark judgments, Sheema versus Ashwini Kumar, it was given by Supreme Court that registration of Hindu marriage is now compulsory. Okay everyone, clear?